All right, many people, I've got one more Zapier workflow for you today. People have been asking, how do you get people to sign up for webinars using Manychat? And this is a cool one because if you use this workflow, you might be able to get people to sign up quicker. You might be able to get more people to sign up. I've seen people increase webinar attendance by 30% by just broadcasting through Messenger and email to remind people of when the webinar is happening. So I'm going to show you really quickly how to get this set up using GoToWebinar and our Zapier integration. Okay. So the first thing that I did for this little test is created a little demo landing page. And here it is. And these are pretty simple to set up, so I won't go through every granular detail here, but here's just a little bit of copy, and here's a send to messenger button. When somebody clicks this button, they're going to get this opt-in action. Okay. Let's click edit to see what this looks like. Now what I've done is I've created a little opt-in action so that when they click on that send to messenger button to register for the webinar, they get a question. It says, hey there, which email address should we send the webinar confirmation to? And what I've done here is I've chosen the reply type to be email, and I have a tag action. So when somebody successfully enters their email address, they will get tagged Zapier webinar registered. This will come in handy later. And then also, as soon as they successfully input their email address, they'll get this quick confirmation message right below here saying, thanks, check your email for your webinar registration confirmation. Okay, this is pretty awesome to set up, really simple. And let me just make sure that we've set everything up correctly here. To get the landing page URL, all you have to do is click setup. And here it is. Let's click on it and see how that looks. Okay, so this is the first step. You have some way to get somebody to engage with you so that they can register for this webinar using Manychat. Now, the second thing you need to do is make sure that the webinar actually exists. So let's head over to GoToWebinar. I've already scheduled a webinar called Zapier Demo. This is just a little test. You can edit it just to see this is actually a real scheduled webinar out in the future at a strange time. And we have one follow-up message that gets sent via email for every webinar registrant. So when you register for one of these, you'll get a confirmation email. So a measure of success of this little demo will be, can we register inside of Manychat using that custom field? Can we zap that over to GoToWebinar, and can we get a confirmation email based on information that I told you in Messenger? That would be really cool, right? So let's go check that out. We have these webinars here. All right, we're all good. Let's go over to Zapier now, because this is where all the magic is going to happen. So I think I may have already set one up to test. Let's just head over there and see if we can see the zaps that we've set up. Here we go. Neat. So I have set one up just to make sure that it is working. And let's actually just create one from scratch, because I want to show you how easy this is to set up. So let's click Make a Zap. We're going to call this GoToWebinar registration using Manychat. All right, let's grab Manychat as the trigger app, because this is where the conversation is going to be happening. It's inside of Messenger. Hey, do you want to join us for this webinar? What's your email address? So what we're going to do is when a new tag is added to the user, we're going to trigger this. Remember how we set up a tag in this growth tool? We're going to go to opt-in actions again and just try to connect the dots here. When somebody successfully puts in their email address, they're going to get a tag, Zapier webinar registered. So what we want to do is when this tag is added to somebody, we want this zap to trigger. So we're going to do new tagged user, save and continue. And we're going to grab this account. This is the one I've been testing on. And we're going to save and continue. Okay, so when this tag, Zapier webinar registered, gets put onto the subscriber in Manychat, this will trigger. We're going to continue. We're going to fetch and continue. What we need to do is to test this properly. What we need to do is tag somebody in our audience, preferably yourself, with this tag. So let's go over to audience. We're going to find me. I think I'm a subscriber. There I am. Apparently I'm a double subscriber. I don't know how that could happen. Let's just grab add tags, and we're going to say Zapier webinar registered. All right, cool. So that should trigger the change, and then let's try again. Zapier webinar registered, continued. Fetch and continue. Test was successful because I just updated that user field. All right, great. So we're going to click continue here. Now we have to set up an action app. So what we're going to do is tag a user in ManyChat, and that's going to trigger a webinar registration. So let's grab GoToWebinar here, create a registrant. And what we're going to, okay, we've already connected this, so this is good. But if you need to connect a new account, it's really simple. You just click that button there. And we're going to test it just to make sure we have a good connection. We do. Let's save and continue. And then this is where the list of upcoming webinars is going to live. So ManyChat Zapier demo is the one that we had set up. And this is where things are really fun. This is where all you can map over all this information from ManyChat. So we already know their first name. If they're a subscriber on ManyChat, we have to know their first name because we're getting that information from Facebook. And we also know their last name. And because you've asked them for their email address in that webinar confirmation, you have their email address too. So let's go ahead and find that here. User custom fields email. All right. Continue. All right, so these are the fields that we're going to map from ManyChat to GoToWebinar using Zapier. We're going to create and continue. And that will do it. So it looks like everything looks okay here. We're going to finish, and we're going to go ahead and turn this on. Okay, so to actually test this, what I'm going to try to do is I'm going to go over to my subscriber here, this one, and what I'm going to do is remove all these tags. So I'm going to remove Zapier webinar register. That's the one that's going to trigger the email inside of GoToWebinar. So let me just make sure, just to double check that that tag is removed from my subscriber because I'm the one who's doing the testing. Testing, Dan. That's my name. Okay, here we are. All right, great. So that tag is not on my account. So theoretically, if I re-tag myself, I will trigger the zap. All right. So let's go over here and make sure this is on. Let's go back to the dashboard. Go to webinar registration using ManyChat. Let's go. This is all good. Okay, I always love like triple checking everything just in case. Let's go to task history to see if this is fired. It has not fired. So there's no reason why this should have misfired already or anything. So let's go ahead and go back to the landing page that I set up and go through the entire flow and see if we get an email. Send to messenger. Okay, yeah, webinars are a great acquisition channel, and that number sounds really fun. So this is how I set it up. Let's open in Messenger. I should get a question. Hey there, which email address should we send webinar registration confirmation to? Actually, I'd like you to send it to dan@manychat.com. And I'm going to press return. Cool. See how it fed it back to me based on that opt-in message that I set up previously? All right, so right now I should be tagged. And I should have an email inbound pretty soon. So let's go check my subscriber. I have been re-tagged with Zapier webinar registered. Now, that should have triggered a zap, so let's go to the dashboard and look at the task history. It does look like it fired, so go to webinar registration using ManyChat did fire. So let's look at the data that ManyChat sent. It sent the tag name, sent my user information, which is amazing, and it sent my email address. Let's go now to data in to go to webinar. It sent my last name, first name, and email address. That's exactly what I wanted. All right, let's go to my webinars in GoToWebinar and see if we have a new registrant. We do. Check this out. Let's go see who signed up. So it looks like it signed up both my email addresses, probably because when I triggered the tag change the first time, it just was looking for a tag change, not a affirmative tag change, so not zero tags to one tag. it was looking for any tag change, so keep that in mind, guys. So I was registered twice, but that's totally fine. For this test, I just wanted to show you that you can actually make a thing happen in GoToWebinar using a ManyChat conversation via Zapier. So what I should have gotten as a confirmation email, let's just go check. Yeah, I did. I got a webinar confirmation in email from an action that I took in Messenger. That is pretty, pretty fun. Hopefully this is kind of just gets the cogs turning for you so that you can start transferring from forms to Messenger as a way of capturing leads, getting their information, and then triggering automations on them. Okay, have fun with this one.